This is Visions by Stevie Wonder. And hello, everyone. I'm Sean Cheek. Welcome to Easy Piano Lessons. The website is www.webpianoteacher.com, or you can contact me at easypianolessons@yahoo.com. And here's part one by special request. And what I did, this is a little bit difficult to transcribe because you have there's not a keyboard part that I hear in the arrangement. There is a string bass and two guitars. Sounds like one acoustic and one electric, and they're all kind of mixing together with different things. And you know, you try to match the arrangement as close as you can with the keyboard part. But so what I have on the my electric keyboard here is a chorus sound and a reverb to kind of give it just a little bit of wetness to the sound. If you just have a piano, that'll work too. If you have a keyboard, you might want to experiment a little bit, try to get something you know, with a little more of an electric piano sound, I think would be better. Now, what we have here in the right hand, what I did is I just transcribed the, you know, the guitar parts and the string bass, and then so let's do that. These first two boxes here are repeated over and over again. The first two, one, two, and I think you repeat it four times in the intro, and then you do it one and a half more times when the singing starts, once Stevie starts singing. So let's look at this here. We have an F sharp below middle C, then a B, then a D, then an E. That's a, you know, a dissonant chord. It's supposed to sound that way. All right, then we have F sharp to C. Bum, bum. So F sharp to middle C sharp. And the rhythm is bum, bum, bum. Again, bum, bum, bum. Okay, and then we have this electric guitar up here going. So we have, we move up to B above middle C, and we go B, C sharp. Okay, and then we play that C sharp again, and then play it again, and then move down to B. Now I put curved lines here because on the guitar you can do what's called a hammer or a pull off, and that's where you don't pick the string for the second note. You just do the fingering on the left hand to make the second note. So we want to make the C sharp softer. And on this one, make the B softer. Because we're pulling off of that on the guitar. So. Now, I just wrote the string bass part verbatim here. We're going to start with, like I said, since we're doing keyboard, you can do a B octave on that first one if you want. But we're down here. And then we're going to play that B again, this low B. Alright? And then C sharp, then D. Then F sharp, then C sharp again, and then a B. And if you're careful about the way you play it, it'll sound kind of cool. and the rhythm is here. You play the B octave, and then. Don't use the pedal too much, because way down low it'll really blur. So. Okay, so. Let's put hands together on this first measure here. Gotta hurry. bum, bum, bum. Okay, so see how these go together? These go together. These go together. This C sharp B is fast. Bum, bum, and this one is slow. One more time on the first box. Okay, second box. G sharp, C sharp, D sharp, E. Okay, dissonant. And then G sharp, D sharp, bum, bum, bum. And then the electric guitar has a middle C sharp, and then up to a high C sharp, to a D sharp, ba-dum. D sharp again, down to a C sharp. So, ba-dum, ba-dum, starting there. Okay, so left hand's gonna have. You can do a C sharp octave. Now I know on the string bass it's probably not doing an octave, but on the keyboard you want to do that. So C sharp, and then just a single G sharp here, and a single F sharp. Okay? So this second box hands together is. Again. Okay, so those are the first two boxes. And you do them, you repeat them several times. Four times for the intro, not with not much variance. And then the singing starts, and you do it, I think, 1.5 more times. So you do, you know, these two boxes, and then you do this box after that just once. Okay, so you do it that one time. And then we go to here. Okay? So anyway, you'll be able to tell when you're listening to it. You do these two boxes over and over again. And then when it, you'll hear the big chord change. Whenever it changes, that's when you start this part. Okay, so that's where you start this, whatever the change is. And we have G, A, C sharp, F sharp. Okay? And then we're going to have G, A again separately. G, A, and then back up to F sharp. Left hand's on an A octave. All right, and so for this box here, we have just bump, 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 bump. You kind of fill in a little bit with the rhythm. You can go a little bit of left hand fill. But I definitely do an octave here on your left hand, and then, you know, thumb and pinky maybe at the end. Okay? Four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we come to this. Really cool chords in here. F, A, B, E. And then F, A, E. Left hand's on a G octave, so we just kind of slide everything down. Four counts on that box as well. Moving on, A, C, E flat, G. Left hand's on an F octave. Ba, 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 ba. You know, I'm playing it twice, but it's just once. It's just four counts. And then you come here, G, B flat, C, F. And then F, C, F. Okay. Left hand's on an E flat octave here. Low. Okay. And then we get here, we have A flat, B flat, D, F sharp. Left hand's on an F sharp octave. And you just roll it, and you hold it for 8 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? Now, when we start this part, it's really these two measures again, because we go back to the singing at the like you had at the beginning of the song, but it's the guitar part is doing something a little different, so I thought I'd throw this in for you for a little variation. And we're going to go D, C sharp, B, F sharp, C sharp, F sharp, B, F sharp. Right like that. Bum, 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 bum. Hold the pedal down. Just keep your hand in that position. Do that measure twice. Left hand's on a B octave here. So we have... kind of mimics what the two guitars are doing together, kind of, you know, squeeze it together there. And then here we have E, D sharp, C sharp, then up to a G sharp, D sharp, G sharp, C sharp, G sharp, lots of sharps. And you do that measure two times as well. So do these measures over and over again, two times, two times, two times, two times, for the next part of the song. Change. So a lot of neat chords in that, chords you don't play very often in music today. So anyway, hope you enjoy it.